the college experience, I think, that may have helped influence my career a lot, is one you might not expect. And that was, as a sophomore, I took a course in Russian literature. It was taught by Edward Wasilek, who was a distinguished professor at the University of Chicago. And in this course, we read some of the great works of Russian literature. But what Wasilek did was, he approached each of those works from a different literary lens. So he approached one from the approach of a Marxist, for example. He approached another work from the approach of someone who took a religious lens to it, to understanding that work. That was really revelatory for me, because it helped me understand that whatever I was going to do in life, my experiences, my biases, were going to matter in terms of how I interpreted what happened around me. So at the end of the day, Professor Wasilek and that experience helped me to think critically. And that's been absolutely vital in my career and everything I've done since. I think college had a tremendous impact on me and really helped shape my view of the world. I think it brought me into contact with individuals that I certainly had never met in my days in high school, in my days in junior high, or in my elementary school. People who were really interested in the life of the mind, who were interested in pursuing intellectual pursuits. That's something I hadn't really seen in high school. People who wanted to talk about Dante and really were interested in philosophers, Kant and Hegel, that I'd never heard of before. And I think that was something special about college, to meet those kind of people, to meet people who were enthused about learning. And I think that really did change my view of the world. I think Beatrice Garber, who was my first research, who helped provide me with my first research experience, was probably the mentor who mattered the most to me in college. She really did introduce me to research, really took me under her wing. I published my first paper eventually as an undergraduate student, so that had a big impact on my career as well. And I think it helped show me that I could be a scientist, that I actually could have a career doing research and being involved in inquiry. So I think she was probably the most important first mentor. So that's made a difference to me. I've never forgotten what it was like to have someone take an interest in me, to have someone really be willing to take the time to help me understand a difficult problem, to point out career pathways for me, to help me understand what the disadvantages and advantages were of pursuing particular interests. I think that's very important. So I think being a mentor is something I care a lot about. I had a great opportunity to do it, particularly when I ran my own laboratory, and in some sense could pay forward what Beatrice Garber did for me. I think research and research universities are absolutely vital to the global community. We face so many problems as a planet, as a world, as a population. We know what number of them are. You name the problem, I think research is critical to solving them. And it's not just research in the basic sciences. As we look at issues like energy, for example, we know research in renewable energy is critical. We have to do that kind of work. We know research in climate change is important. We have to do that kind of work. But it's also research in the social sciences that are critical too. You can't solve a problem like climate change without understanding the environmental and social factors that drive people to behave in the ways they do, that incent particular behaviors that may be important. All of the disciplines become critical in solving these kinds of problems. And without research, we're not going to get the kind of answers we need to solve these problems. And I think for the sake of our planet, for the sake of the generations that are coming, we have to do a better job. So I think higher education is vital to the future of the United States and the world. I think if you look at the problems that face us today, we talk a lot about income inequality. The one sure path out of income inequality is higher education. Individuals who get a college degree, and now even a bachelor's or master's degree, are going to have lifetime earnings and opportunities that you don't have if you don't have that degree. This is the path out of poverty, is higher education. And so we have to make it affordable, we have to make it accessible, and we have to make it excellent as well. So investment in higher education, investment both in the infrastructure of higher education as well as the people involved in higher education, and supporting students and giving them access is going to be absolutely vital to our future. So we have to make the investment in higher education. We need an educated populace. It's the way to address income inequality. And at the same time, we have to be able to tackle these difficult problems we face. And universities, and research universities in particular, help us do that.